Our forecasters say the odds of Irene swinging out to sea and avoiding landfall are now slim. This could be a billion-dollar weather disaster. And you hear all the time, be prepared, have an emergency kit. Well, now we're not kidding. Eitan Edwards is the author of Preparedness Now, and he works with organizations like the Red Cross to deal with situations just like this. Okay, Eitan, I don't think we can say strongly enough to people, this is serious. So what do they have to do to prepare?
Yeah, what people need to do right now is to start to assemble what's called a grab-and-go bag. Now, this essentially is a bag that contains all the items that you'd need to live outside of your home for an extended period. Generally speaking, some people say 72 hours, but I'd say more than that, because when we saw it, like with Katrina, that a lot of people were still in distress a week after they were, you know, after the event. So what you want to do is you want to get together some essential items in that bag that will allow you to survive outside of your home for that period.
Or even survive in your home if you don't have power, because I think that the prediction is there could be widespread power outages that could go on for a while.
That's right. So what people have to do is, you know, not only get their grab-and-go bag together, get the essential items together. Like, for instance, you've got some items laid out here. We've got your important documents, insurance documents, your last will and testament, things like that you can put inside of plastic bags.
Some cash,
but low denominations. In a lot of cases, people go running to ATMs after disasters. And so what you have is, like if you can see, is a $5 bill. Nothing more than a five, singles, fives, and tens. Nothing larger than that, because if you have bills that are 50s and hundreds, you know, you might have to buy a loaf of bread. Unless you want to pay $100 for it, it's not a good idea to have, like, large denominations of bills. Another thing you want to have handy are flashlights. But, you know, nowadays we have these hand crank flashlights. This is an Energizer solar and hand crank, so that you don't have to worry about getting batteries for your flashlight, your essential items. Having an emergency radio that's also a crank emergency radio is preferable than a battery. And because if you need some batteries and during a disaster, it's very difficult to find batteries, because people are just, like, buying them.
Which is why you should have extras always.
You need to have lots of extras.
Especially a radio like that. People let them sit around for years and never turn them on.
Now, what you've also got to have is, you know, you have your cell phone here. It's really important to have your cell phone and a charger. And if you can, there are little crank chargers that you can get, because you might not have.
This is critical for people, because I didn't think about this. If there's a power outage and you can't charge your phone, and how many people now don't have a landline?
That's right.
And you need to figure out how you're going to keep this thing charged.
Yeah, and they have little hand crank chargers that you can get for your cell phone, so that just in case it is an emergency power outage that you don't have any power, you can still crank that phone, you can still get some power.
And I can get that at, like, Radio Shack or Target or...
Right. Walmart. Now, the difficulty with water is there's a certain amount of water that you need to carry, but unfortunately, because of the weight, you know, like, 1 cubic foot of water is about 64 pounds. You're not going to carry 64 pounds of water in your back, you know, unless, of course, you're, you know, like a professional wrestler or something. Oh, well, I wouldn't carry 64 pounds. You know, what you want to do is that they're trail filters, they're trail water filters that you can get that you can actually use to purify the water, because in a lot of cases, your power outages are going to prevent water treatment facilities from actually functioning properly. Oftentimes, you get contaminated water. So people need to have the ability to drink clean water, and there are water filters that are available. There are little straw filters that you can use. There are all kinds of water filters available that you can use in a disaster to keep the water fresh so that you don't get a waterborne disease.
You know, I heard something that we should always prepare for one category above the storm that we're expecting.
Yeah, you always do a little bit extra, because the more that you prepare, the better off you are. You have to prepare for the worst and then hope for the best. So you've got to go a little bit more than what you need. And right now, people need to get cracking, because, you know, and oftentimes you see with these disasters, people just stand around and then they hope for things to kind of get better. This is a situation where we cannot hesitate. I'd urge all Americans that are in line of this disaster right now to get serious, to start to prepare their homes. If you have stuff in the basement when the storm surge comes, if you have valuables in your basement, get it up and above that storm surge, because what's going to happen is there's going to be a lot of flooding. There's going to be a lot of damage. This could be, like you said, it's $1 billion, to maybe much more than $1 billion. I hope not. But the fact of the matter is that people need to start acting now to prevent these things from happening in the future.
Eitan, critical advice. Thank you so much for coming in.
Thank you.
And right now, that storm is tearing across the Bahamas, and MSNBC producer Essa Yip has been riding out the storm with her family, not in their room at the hotel, but at an emergency shelter at the Atlantis Resort. Right now, she's been sending us video showing the scene outside the resort on Paradise Island, right across the bridge from Nassau. About 1,400 people are staying in the ballrooms as the storm batters the islands. Essa says people were given just a blanket and a pillow and basically told, make camp on the floor. But the resort is providing meals and snacks. There you get a look at where all the people are staying inside the Atlantis. Atlantis. And so if you're anywhere near the east coast of the United States, you'll need to hear our next report on just what this storm could mean for you.